Thanks. I'll buy you a drink the next time you're at Fort Hays. Hello, Bates.
Glad to see you back, Colonel.
Waiting long?
Well, it was getting kind of lonesome waiting out here. A fellow my size gets to be a pretty easy target.
Depends on who's doing the shooting.
Oh, right over there, Colonel.
Sorry to drag you all the way out here, Bates.
There won't be a stagecoach to Fort Hays for another week.
Well, the telegram said you didn't want an escort, Colonel. But with all the dust being kicked up by Fire Cloud and his people around here lately.
All the more reason for no escort. Just two men riding hard. Won't make them quite as nervous.
Yes, sir. Any good in Washington, Colonel?
I doubt it. Sat 2 hours with General Sheridan, talked myself blue in the face, while his orderly kept me behind a wall of cucumber sandwiches.
And the 7th will go right on doing garbage detail instead of soldiering.
I wouldn't say you've been totally deprived of using your weapons or a chance to lose your scalp.
Yes, sir.
He had been the youngest general in the Civil War. Within 5 years, he had been reduced in rank and sent west to be forgotten. But he was not the kind of man to let the world forget. His name, George Armstrong Custer.
Custer on my way back to Fort Hays. I'd appreciate a ride.
If you don't have any room, I don't mind sharing space with the baggage.
You're all alone, huh?
As you see me.
Uh-huh. Colonel in the cavalry. No horse, no baggage, no orderly.
Very nearly no colonel. We were attacked by Indians. I lost a man back there.
We're leaving in a few minutes. Go have some grub.
Thank you.
You know who that is, don't you?
Who?
Custer.
Who?
George Armstrong Custer, the boy general, ex-general. Once known as the Prince of Cavaliers. Now doing penance at Fort Hayes, commanding the dregs of the dregs of the U.S. Cavalry. No need to be afraid of him.
You want to ride with us, Colonel, I ought to warn you. This country's swarming. Like a nest of hornets been poked with a sharp stick.
I've had occasion to notice it.
Auxiliary zoo, without war paint. Combing this country like a giant posse. So they told us at the last station anyways. All seems to me like they're looking for somebody.
Reasonable assumption.
Reckon it might be you, Colonel Custer?
I've been in Washington for the past 3 weeks.
Indians got better memories than that.
Mister, even if I were that important, they couldn't possibly know I'm back.
All right. Get aboard.
Hey, Brown. I ain't no hurry if you ain't.
You use that elbow once more and I'll break it. Come on. Custer. Ned Quimbo is my name. Honored to know you, sir. I bet I've read every word ever written about you.
I'm glad I can't say the same.
You're too modest, sir. I'm a journalist, and I hope to add a few thousand words to the legend before this trip is over.
You ask before you borrow anything from me, mister.
Think fast and act faster, Colonel Custer. I want to thank you.
It's all right. But I think you and your friend better go first this time.
Let's go. Few men become legends in their own lifetime. And what made them legends wasn't their own spectacular deeds. No, sir, it was the pen of men like yours truly that engraved their names in the affections of their countrymen.
Go ahead. Right up, Custer. And never mind about the facts. You'll swallow every word and buy 100 copies to dispatch to every congressman and senator as might do him some good.
Why else would a man wear a uniform in peacetime? If you weren't lusting after glory.
Or you could write me up instead. Let's see, you could call it Uvalde, the outlaw of the plains.
You could sell copies at my hanging.
You'll be swinging long before they set the first stick of type. Perhaps you need someone like me to tell the world the truth about you, or what you would like them to consider to be the truth.
You do me too much honor, Mr. Quimbo. If you really wish to write about a man who is a living legend,
May I suggest you seek the acquaintance of Chief Crazy Horse of the Oglala Sioux?
Do you hold all your enemies in such high regard, Colonel?
As a good Christian, I always turn the other cheek, but not my back.
Isn't it a pity that so little of your Christian generosity was in evidence when you were fighting us?
You lost your husband in the war. You have my sympathy. Perhaps for such losses we should blame war itself, not the color of a uniform.
We're ready to go. Get aboard.
Targets here.
Got to stop. I'll find a shallow place to cross.
That water looks shallow enough to ford.
Better take a look at it. Can't risk getting bogged down.
I'm his replacement.
Just keep...
Throw down your gun.
The banks get these things off me.
Let's have the key.
How far do you think you'll get?
Cloud has war parties all over these hills. You'll never get out of here alive. Not on your own.
We ain't about to take any witnesses with us.
We haven't done you any harm.
Well, you ain't done me much good either. What do you say we take her with us, huh?
I'll go with you, too.
You'd be better off if they shot you right here. They'd have to, sooner or later.
How would you get us out of here alive, soldier man?
Today's the 26th. Company C of the 7th Cavalry is scheduled for maneuvers a few miles from here.
Where?
Where?
Was saying, you don't get out of here alive unless we do. All of us.
Of novels about these types. They're like primitive children, dangerous only if provoked.
General?
I heard you had a rumpus with some bucks back at the creek. That don't prove they're out there now in full force. We've been here all day. And I ain't seen no sign of them.
When was the last time you had a look around? Keep down!
Good bluffing, Mr. Colonel, but it won't wear. All I can see out there is...
Now, do we get our guns back?
We'll try nothing.
I promise nothing, but I'll try and help us stay alive. Get inside.
Jake.
Milbanks did it.
The Indians won't attack again until the sun is low enough to blind us. No need for more than one of us to stay out here in this heat.
I'll bury Jake, and I got the first watch.
Water's gonna have to last us for a while.
Colonel, you ain't in charge of this fort now.
Your brass don't mean nothing around here now.
I think somebody should be in command.
Not you.
I suspect I'm qualified. If you want to challenge that, you'd better do it right here and now. Guns or fist, any way you want it.
Let's save our ammunition for the Indians. Admiral? Who's your gun belt, Brewster?
Colonel Custer. But you wouldn't remember. The crying women you passed during the war. They meant nothing to you, did they?
I'm not the first to say or to think that, Mrs. Moffat. The spoils of war aren't usually what is imagined.
You're alive.
A soldier learns to live with the sudden possibility of death. And dying, that's not the hardest part. It's the problems you leave for those who survive you.
You mean that, don't you?
Haven't you been told never to believe a Yankee man?
Boy General. Dashing cavalier. Hear me, General?
Take your hand off me, Uvalde.
If the lady don't mind too much, supposing she try her luck at rustling up some grub for us. From the looks of things, we just might be here for some time.
Some coffee might help.
Gotta hand it to you, General. Fancy uniform, a reputation to match. Really works. One minute she hates your guts, and next time she...
Thank you. Mr. Uvalde. As an experienced man of the West, do you think that it's really only Custer the Indians are after?
Ain't no doubt in the world about it. In my mind.
My opinion exactly.
There's a guard out here.
Yeah, I'll keep you company. Where are you going?
To find out if it's me Fire Cloud is after.
You out of your head?
You expect to learn what that savage has in his mind.
I'm going to ask him.
Sir, if I get out of this alive...
I know. You'll make mention of me in your writings in the most generous of terms.
Generous? I shall make you immortal. Why do you smile? Can you truly be unaware that the hand that holds the pen is the hand that rules the world?
I've been made only too painfully aware of that, Mr. Quimbo. On more than one occasion... Diedrix, lock up after me.
Colonel Custer. Please take care.
Yes, ma'am. What Firecloud wants. It isn't like the great warrior Firecloud to send hundreds of braves into a land where he cannot hope to prevail against our cavalry. Not without the most serious of reasons.
Firecloud have that.
Reason enough to leave the safety of the hills?
Reason enough!
The people left alive in that station. What makes them so important that you would risk the lives of your braves?
Firecloud had a son. One of them. He killed son of Firecloud.
Which one?
The man you call Uvalde.
Firecloud, believe me. That man is under the sentence of death. He escaped from prison and was being returned by a U.S. Marshal to await execution.
To hang without pain. To be dead in the blink of an eye. Without time to scream for mercy.
Yes. That is the law. That and no other.
We will take him from you to give him death of my choosing. Give him to us. You will all go free.
Fire Cloud, I'm an officer, sworn to uphold the law. I will not. I cannot give you what you want.
We will come and take him. At any cost. You will die. All of you will die. I will not speak of this again.
And nothing else, then why don't you just turn him over and spare the rest of us?
You don't really believe that Fire Cloud would let us go, do you? No, he might not order us killed, but he wouldn't stop it either.
So what if you're wrong? What have we lost? The thorn in our side?
That'll be enough out of you.
You're a hard man to convince, Uvalde.
We'll need what strength we have left to keep Firecloud from overrunning us.
When do you think he'll attack?
And it won't cost him too many men.
Since when do they care about casualties? I always thought to a redskin, life was cheaper than dirt.
You shouldn't believe everything you write, Mr. Quimbo. The Sioux is a deadly fighter, but he loves life. As much as you or I. When it isn't maintained at the expense of honor.
Honor? Among savages?
Perhaps we could do with a little more of that honor ourselves.
May I have some water? I'd like to thank you, Colonel Custer. Valdi would have...
You asked for it, Mrs. Muffin.
I know I did. I goaded him into it, but... Well, a man like that...
He's facing death the same as the rest of us. And if Firecloud has his way, it won't be quick and it won't be pleasant. Remember, his life means as much to him as ours does to us.
I know that. It just seems so unfair for our lives to be in jeopardy to save a man... Well, a man already condemned to death.
Would you turn him over to Firecloud? Knowing what would happen?
No. It's only...
The chance that we may die here?
I felt for a long time I had nothing to live for after my husband was killed. Everything had just come to an end. But things do go on, and we find ourselves living for the moment. Picking up the pieces of our lives again. Remembering all the things we once planned to do, to accomplish. You have a dream too, Colonel Custer?
A bigger dream, Mrs. Moffat, than I have any right to expect to come true. Get some rest.
I'm fine, thank you. Any sign of him?
No, not yet.
It's most unusual for Indians to attack at night. The legend has it that their souls can't find their way into the next world in the darkness.
Are children afraid of the dark? Simple, childlike, and more terrible than any other people on this earth.
But they are people with the same human weakness and frailty as the rest of us.
I wouldn't call you weak. Or afraid of anything, for that matter.
Well, different men fear different things.
But you're not afraid of death.
I've lived too long with it to be afraid of it. But that's enough of this kind of talk. We'll get out of this somehow. Now, you want to try and get some rest?
I'm fine here.
This will make my most exciting novel, and every word of it true.
Save me a copy, Quimbo. I'd like to know how it turns out.
Why, of course, Colonel Custer.
And while you're at it, don't forget to include my pal, Fireclan.
I would give my soul to be able to do just that. To understand a great chief, committed to an all-out war against the mightiest nation on earth, fighting for all the barbaric things he believes in.
You make it all sound very romantic, Quimbo. But in truth, there's no romance in these Indian wars, and no absolute right on either side.
Now, what are you doing?
Trying to get us out of here if I'm lucky.
Custer's luck. I hope it's still working. You know Firecloud will have a guard out there someplace.
Sure. I'm not back in 20 minutes. You're on your own, Diedrichs. And I wish you luck. Much of a plan. It's the best chance we've got. You'll go out straight away from here, about a mile, you'll cross the stagecoach road. If you keep low and move carefully, you should be able to make it before daylight.
What about you?
I've got to try and get us out of this trap.
How?
By distracting Firecloud long enough to give us a head start. When you see that stagecoach coming, get ready. Start moving.
Nothing to lose.
You'll have a better chance if you stay together.
Mm.
Quimbo. Quimbo!
No, 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 I don't want to go.
Get out that window.
Firecloud isn't after me. He has no reason to kill me.
Believe me, Quimbo, he doesn't need one. The kind you'd understand.
I don't believe that.
Believe what you want, but get out that window. Now! Hurry! It's getting light. His life, Firecloud wouldn't kill him. I hope he's won.
No, 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 Firecloud. I want to speak to Firecloud. Firecloud, do you realize that you are a living legend? I will engrave your name upon the hearts of... No, 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 you don't understand.
Broken line. Can't go on until it's fixed.
Will it take long?
Oh, not long. There's a leather awl and some cord in the gearbox.
I'll get it.
Drop your gun belt, Custer.
Move! Are you insane, Uvalde?
Drop your gun belt. Custer.
Cut the horses loose, Brewster. We're riding out.
What about the woman?
Well, that's up to her. She can stay here.
Or she can ride with us.
Your time just ran out, Uvalde. Fire cloud.
You're just full of cute little tricks, aren't you, soldier boy?
Don't shoot. Not yet.
You won't let him take us alive.
Fire cloud.
All right, ma'am. Ready to pull out?
In just a minute, please.
Be no danger the rest of the way. It's time for goodbyes, Mrs. Moffat. I'm staying here to meet my troop.
I'm very happy to have had the opportunity to have known you, Colonel Custer.
My privilege to know you, ma'am.
However, there is something that needs to be said. I have reason to like you, respect you, but you still stand for everything I hate. War and senseless, brutal killing. Everything that you men call glory.
I can't deny that, Mrs. Moffat. But I heard a great man once say, as much as I respect your opinion, I respect my duty more.
One of your Yankee heroes, Colonel Custer?
No, madam. That was General Robert E. Lee.